When you've been through trauma, you tend to leave the bottom three chakras to then go in the top three chakras. And then you can tune to everybody else, and you've lost the sense of self. You've abandoned your body to then get your needs met, to tune to everybody else to make them happy versus saying, what the hell do I want? One of the biggest things people do with abandonment is they abandon themselves to make other people happy. Think about that. How many times have you abandoned yourself to please someone else or to gain or receive love? When I look at my past, I developed this people pleaser, nice guy attitude that I also probably adjusted from my dad. And I had to shed that this last 2 years. I had to realize the truth of it. People pleasing and being a nice guy is a shadow. It is a shadow that says, I'm afraid of abandonment from you, so I will be nice to you and I will not give you tension. I won't make you think anything bad about me. I will control and manipulate what you think about me, and I will put on this best facade that I'm this really nice person so that you will not feel tension or bad about me, because I really want your approval and validation, because I didn't receive approval and validation when I was a kid the way I wanted to. Maybe if I get these YouTube plaques on the wall and I feel and I help millions of people, maybe then I'll be significant and I'll feel good about myself, because I don't feel good about myself naturally. You see, this is how the shadow plays out. In some ways, the shadow has helped me. The shadow has helped me become successful on YouTube by wanting and helping as many people as I can. But at the same time, I have to eventually realize that I'm worthy for just being me, not for how many videos I make, not for anything else. And I need to stop abandoning myself to try to please everybody else. Now, at the same time, I'm passionate about making videos, but it's not that I change what I do. I change how I do it, the energy from which it comes from. But one of the biggest drugs that you'll want if you feel abandoned as a kid is you probably have become a nice, like, you become afraid of tension. And because I had the ex-stepmom from 7 to 15 years old, and imagine that too. I then have felt abandoned from 7 to 15, having the abusive ex-stepmom in my life who's a narcissist. 7 to 15, my dad divorced her when I was 15. But in that time, my dad is a firefighter. He was gone 24 hours a day, here 24 hours a day. But he was gone a lot, so we felt abandoned there, but also we felt abandoned because he allowed a lot of the stuff to happen with my ex-stepmom. So then there were moments when he chose her over us. And that was, I remember that being a big deal. I remember thinking, man, we have nowhere to go, you know, because she brainwashed my brother and I not to have a relationship with our real mom. She'd like encourage us to write mean notes to her and shit. So from 7 to 15, we didn't have our real mom in the picture. And once she got more and more control, then my brother and I, like, there were times I wanted to run away when I was like 14, 15 years old towards the end. But where would I go? You know, I have no idea. No, that's like Stockholm Syndrome too. It's like we wanted to leave. We didn't like what was going on, but we felt safe. Even though we had to lie about shit, we had to like fucking weasel around our ex-stepmom because she was so crazy. But that sense of certainty is also a drug. You know, so how that played out, though, was the tension that we experienced from our ex-stepmom because she was so abusive. That's bad. So we need her to like us in order for us to like survive and get by. And with the different, you know, we had to tune ourselves. You know, I've talked about this with my masculine integration coach. We had to tune ourselves to. We had to tune ourselves to the feminine emotion, which wasn't, she was more masculine, my ex-stepmom, but we had to tune ourselves to it and kind of gauge ourselves. So the masculine work for my brother and I, for me at least, was I had to get more into my own frame and my own body and stop tuning myself to the feminine emotion, knowing that it's just something that fluctuates. I developed my own sense of gravity. But one of the main things I had to do is I had to realize what is authentic versus what is manipulative. And because my ex-stepmom was manipulative, because we felt like we had to manipulate to get our needs met as kids, the people pleasing and everything, we then would attract people that were manipulative. I've had ex-girlfriends that were manipulative. And the key to this, one, the big domino, once again, is to stop abandoning the self, to bring the awareness back to the self, to start asking yourself, what do I want? Who am I? What is authentic for me? Now, I'm much more polarizing than I was 8 months ago to a year ago. I say what I actually feel. If something comes up between me and a friend, I tell them. I say, hey, this is what's coming up for me. I'm not afraid of that. I used to be. I'm not afraid, like, I it's easy for me to set boundaries. I used to have a problem setting boundaries. I've had friends that kind of take advantage, or at least I let them. It's not that they took advantage, it's that I let them and they got used to it and comfortable with that. So I had to learn to set boundaries. No, this is not okay. I'm not going to do this. And as I started setting those boundaries, I started feeling empowered because I started bringing I stopped abandoning myself for other. And that's the way this reality works. You know, something that we talk about, there's something called the frame technique. The frame technique is simply where you bring the energy back into your body and you start feeling safe in your own body. And there's a meditation practice for this, but then you feel the separation between you and other people and you will have way more magnetic energy. It works like magic. I started using this and I would go to the store, I'd go out and people would just, the different level of presence that comes with this, different level of respect that comes with this, and you heal a lot of there's either self or other. When you're standing in a candle flame, there's you and there's the flame. And when you feel the separation, you start to feel safe in your own body. So this is something that changes everything. And by the way, one of the biggest blocks to attracting love is the abandonment wound. It is feeling abandoned from other people, thinking that they're constantly going to leave you or thinking that you have to change your center of gravity to tune to them. And until you heal the abandonment wound, there's going to be this fear. There's going to be this like fear people are going to leave you and you're going to put up with relationships. Part of that for me was I was putting up with relationships that were not serving me for way longer than needed. Also, my dad was in a marriage for 7 years with my ex-stepmom, probably 5 years too long. He didn't catch the red flags. So what I would do is I'd be in relationships where my common pattern was I would choose people who didn't choose me because that felt normal. I would choose people that wouldn't choose me. Because then I would try to fix them. And what I'm secretly trying to do with the abandonment wound is that if I can fix somebody, then I can get them to work again and love me the way that I want to be loved. So the fixing is a mechanism. It's a manipulative mechanism that I would use to get people to love me rather than having the boundaries or the self-love for myself to then realize if I'm in a relationship and somebody's not choosing me to just end it. That's what I did. I did that. And once I did that, then I was actually able to attract love. In a very powerful way. But I had to let go. And that's why, you know, a lot of times when people go through breakups too, they're afraid that if they go through a breakup and somebody chooses someone else other than them, then it means they're not worthy. Here's one of the biggest things with the abandonment wound is realize it had nothing to do with you. We internalize a level of shame. We think, oh, my mom or dad's emotional unavailability when a kid means I'm not worthy. No, it does not mean you're not worthy. It means they had their own shit going on. But we internalize it. Shame is an internalized identity emotion. There's something broken with me. There's nothing broken with you. Your parents divorced when you were 5 was not because of you. It was their own shit. It wasn't because you weren't worthy. It was their own shit. So this is about healing the abandonment wound. And that's something that we do in something called the 21-Day Magnetic Love Challenge. So if you haven't heard about it yet, you go to aarondoughty.com/love. It's 21 days to a more magnetic, higher vibrational you. And basically the key is raising your vibration, raising your love vibration, and letting go of codependent, needy behaviors through healing childhood wounds. When you do this, everything changes. It's way easier than you think. You think, oh, I've had too many childhood wounds or I haven't had enough childhood wounds. No. When you become aware of this stuff, it is like a whole new world. The moment I started becoming aware that the shame from childhood and the worthiness from childhood had nothing to do with me, my life started to change. I started to attract options into my life. It can happen very quick and it's very easy when you apply it. So that's something that we're doing for 21 days, the Magnetic Love Challenge. We're going to be doing one of the bonuses that you get right now if you join as well is the frame technique bonus, which is a whole workshop that shows you step by step how to apply what I'm talking about to feel that separation and have that magnetic energy. It's 21 days in a row of going live with experts. It's like a 21-day live event for a ridiculously cheap price for you to get in. And you can join right now by going to aarondoughty.com/love. Also, my shadow work integration coach will be doing a live call answering questions on masculine and feminine energy. There's bonuses that you'll see there as well with other relationship coaches. So it's going to be very powerful, and I can't wait to do this. So if you want to join, go to aarondoughty.com/love and join the Magnetic Love Challenge. And in general, when it comes to abandonment, realize the key is not abandoning the self, and it starts to realize who are you, and it means really getting in your body. It sounds simple, by the way, getting in your body. Like, why would the answer be getting inside of my body? Like, the answer is go in your body. When you've been through trauma, you tend to leave the bottom three chakras to then go in the top three chakras. And then you can tune to everybody else. And you've lost the sense of self. You've abandoned your body to then get your needs met, to tune to everybody else to make them happy versus saying, what the hell do I want? You know, I'm now like more interested in some things. I wasn't like, I mean, I love UFC. I'm going to Austin. So I want to be doing like MMA and stuff. Because when you get in your body and you feel tension from other people, or you're in that like that mode, I feel like it helps develop a sense of self, maybe even a sense of ego. But a lot of people that have abandoned themselves have low sense of self-worth, low sense of self-esteem. And it's because it's like we're all one. We're all one consciousness. Yes, that's true, but we're also individual like avatars having this human experience. So feeling safe in your own body is really key, and putting the awareness inside your body more often is key. And asking, like, really what happens too is your value system changes. My value system used to be I value people's approval and validation. I really value what people think of me. After I went through my transformation and I started bringing the energy back to myself, I value authenticity. I value integrity. I value honesty. And that changes everything. You can switch your values. That's something else we do in the 21-Day Magnetic Love Challenge. We recognize the version of us, that the way we've been and the codependent patterns we've been living, and we let go of those values. And it's a very easy process, but we simply start being the version of us that has the ideal relationship, the depth of relationship, that doesn't have the intimacy blocks, the attachment styles, whatever it is. We just take on those values knowing we can, and it's very easy to do. Now I value authenticity. Yes, I'm more polarizing. I like being that way. I'm not afraid anymore. Reminds me of like, is that a Home Alone thing? I was like, I'm not afraid anymore. I think that's like a quote from that or something. But the key to this, and imagine that. Imagine Home Alone. Imagine Macaulay Culkin. The abandonment wound that he must have felt in the movie Home Alone. His parents literally forgot about him. So imagine Macaulay Culkin. Kevin is chilling in his house. His parents and mom forgets him not once. How many Home Alones are there? Two or three? His mom repetitively abandoned him. He's got a mother wound. Macaulay Culkin in Home Alone has a mother wound where he is afraid that his parents are constantly going to leave, not just once, but twice. And then it's like, think about the negative self-beliefs that come from that. It's like, I'm not worthy. I'm forgotten in this pool of children. Maybe I'm, you know, imagine later on in relationships, he's going to feel that abandonment wound as well. So he can heal it. He's going to have to bring the energy back to himself and realize that his mom's emotional unavailability and physical abandonment had nothing to do with him. It was her own shit. She has a lot of kids. It's taking it out of the identity and realizing that also it was for the movie. There's different level of awarenesses here. Imagine like you're in this life. And your mom abandons you, your dad abandons you, and you make this meaning, I'm not worthy. First off, this whole reality that we're in is a virtual reality that we set up so we can have different human experiences so that we can learn from it. So in a way, Home Alone is a set. It's also a symbol because our life is this virtual reality that we think is real, but it's just these experiences and meanings of things that have happened that we then get to redecide who we are. I hope you guys enjoyed that little segment from my podcast called the Aaron Doughty Podcast. If you want to listen to the rest of that episode, click the link below. You'll see it on iTunes and Spotify. You can download episodes. It's so easy to listen to. You can do it while you're working out, while you're driving. It's so convenient. And that's where new episodes go live every Tuesday and Thursday, every single week. I have guests coming on the podcast. I have solo episodes, and we go really deep. This is really a place where I get very personable and I share more about things I'm thinking of. I share my top book insights, and you can check it out and subscribe below and you will see it there. So iTunes, Spotify, listen to the rest of the episode below as well. And I hope you guys enjoyed, And as always, I'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace, much love, and namaste.